What is up, PSG family, and welcome back. You guys voted. Okay, I left a post on my community. I said, if you guys want me to start a new dynasty with a different team, I want you guys to come through and vote. You guys voted, and I also asked you guys to say what team you would like in the comments. So it came down to the Mavericks, and it came down to the New York Knicks. Each had 4 votes. So I'm like, okay, we got to decide which one of these teams we're going to run with. So I went to Coin Flipper. Right, we need a coin to flip with so we can decide between the Mavs and the Knicks. It's going to come down between those two teams. A lot of guys voted. I appreciate all the votes that you guys came through with. The Utah Jazz almost came up with 4 votes as well, but it came down to the Knicks. It came down to the Mavs. So heads means we're going to be running with the Knicks. Okay, I'm going to write it out for you guys in case you're not listening. You can see on screen, you probably can't even understand anything this says. I don't even know what I'm writing, to be honest. But here comes Tails. So Tails are going to be in Mavericks. Heads is going to be the Knicks. So let's get a little suspenseful music going right now so we can, you know, build the mood up. Who's it going to be? And we're going to be running with the Knicks. So the great coin has flipped. We are going to be running with the New York Knicks. But before we get started in our first game against the OKC Thunder, we got to release one player. Well, somebody has to go. Somebody's cut. Okay, the season hasn't started, you gotta go. And this was a pretty easy decision for me to make. I just went all the way to the bottom of the roster. And I know, I believe this guy's, I believe he's a rookie, I'm not too sure. But he has to go, because he's an overall 64. And, you know, it's a little bit too low, so I'm not gonna keep him around. We got other rookies on the roster at point guard. We got Ron Baker, Frank as well. So we got a pretty solid point guard lineup that is young. So we're going against the OKC Thunder in game number 1, which is not going to be fun for me, because remember, I already played the OKC Thunder without Carmelo Anthony in my Chicago Bulls dynasty. So now I got to come through and play against them with Carmelo Anthony. And you guys saw the little controller disconnect right there. Okay, that was just a metaphor for how this game was, or at least how this first quarter was for us, because this is what you call a disconnect from your offense and from your defense. And it's Cancer with a nice rebound right there. He would go to the line, but he'd only make one. He wouldn't even make a free throw. Never mind. I thought he made a free throw. He didn't. But Doug McDermott goes to the line right there again, and he would make one free throw. But Russell Westbrook just comes in through the lane, flying through the lane and throwing down. And these guys were just going insane on us. So it's 1-5. We're still looking for our first bucket. Porzingis misses that easy jumper. Okay, that wasn't easy. I don't know why I said it was easy. That was pretty tough. But here come OKC Thunder. Once again, Carmelo Anthony going all the way this time. 7-1. Doug McDermott misses the 3-ball right there. And I'll be real, I'm taking some contested shots, but I'm just trying to get on the board. This is a pretty good look. Misses that one as well. So it's 1-9. 1-9. Another easy 3-ball. Misses. 1-9, guys. And I mean, they would just continue to pack it on. All hell is breaking loose. Man, this is not a good start to the New York Knicks dynasty. Kristaps Porzingis goes to the lane. No, he gets fouled. And I would only make 1 of 2 at the line from his 2 to 11. And that's just such a weird score. That's some good defense right there. But we're not grabbing that rebound. And they get another easy bucket. So we're getting loose on this fast break. Doug McDermott beats his man. Goes to the lane. And he doesn't get fouled, actually. He just misses. He just missed. Okay, I was going to say he got fouled. He didn't even do that. So the 3-ball comes. And they make it a 2-16 point lead. PSG, what's going on? Trust me, I have no idea. Doug McDermott. Nice move. Finally, we are on the board with our first field goal. I mean, we had our first points, but we hadn't made an actual shot. So we finally got that to go through. And Tim Hardaway comes off the bench, gets a quick 2 points as well. So we're kind of working our way back in this game, despite how bad of a start we had. You know, we got 8 points now. Okay, and I got a few excuses to make here, right? This wouldn't be a good video unless I made some excuses as to why I'm getting destroyed right now. Okay, it's been a few days since I played NBA Live, which I guess isn't too solid of an excuse. But this is the first time I used the New York Knicks, which also I guess isn't too solid of an excuse. What I'm just trying to say is I'm pretty bad. Okay, I'm pretty bad at playing with the New York Knicks right now. But I promise you guys I'm going to pull it together. Look at this move by Russell Westbrook, man. Just flying through the lane. These guys had a 16-point lead. Courtney Lee takes a strong to the rim. We need more of that. We need more drives. We need some 3-balls to fall for us so we can get this game back in control. Because OKC is just like, all right, forget you, dude. You're completely trash right now. So we're still in the second quarter, about 5 minutes to go. OKC Thunder moving the ball around. You see they got that mismatch, so they attacked it and they scored off of it. Now back we come, down by 19 points. I go to Porzingis. I'm like, just save us, man. He gets this nice little perfect release fadeaway over Carmelo Anthony. Clean move right there as we work our way back into this game. So I don't know if you guys are noticing, but I'm using a new microphone. Let me know how it sounds in the comments below. Does it sound good? Does it sound worse? From what I've heard in terms of feedback, I believe it sounds much better than my old microphone. But again, let me know in the comments what you guys think, because that's obviously most important as a community. Now we get a nice three ball right here from Courtney Lee, working our way back in this game. It's a 14-point game, guys. But Russell Westbrook gets his tough and one. Can't stop the guy. Literally cannot stop the guy. A minute to go in the second quarter. I'm going back into Porzingis, who gets a nice little and one on his own. So Porzingis literally lifted us. He's carrying us through the second quarter because we need everything we can get. But Russell Westbrook, honestly, I can't stop him. He has 21 points. 21. We're not even in the second half yet. We're still in the second quarter. Michael Beasley hits a nice jumper right there. We go into the third quarter. And look at Carmelo Anthony. What got into this man? What? He just drives all the way from one end of the court to the other just to throw down on us. I guess he really just hates the Knicks, man. I guess he's just taking out his anger and his frustration in this game. So we make it a 15-point game. Some good defense by Enes Kanter, but once again, we don't grab the rebound. They score, and we're down by 17 once again. Doug McDermott, little three ball right here. And this is where Dougie McBuckets catches a little bit of fire. Okay, Russell Westbrook is going to miss that jumper. We're going to get loose and running on this fast break. But look in the bottom left corner. Look at that man standing there. Okay, we're going to go straight to him. This is a decoy play, the driving kick out to Doug McDermott for the perfect release three ball. You see him? He was holding that follow through. He knew that was good. PG-13 trying to match. Not happening, because Doug McDermott is the better player. Okay, Doug's better than PG-13. Yeah, I said it. Kristaps Porzingis, what a beautiful little reverse. Nice little, I don't even know, a little cradle, a little reverse. That was something. It was nice. So it's an 11-point game. We've worked our way back into this behind Doug McDermott, and he ain't done just yet. Look at the man in his face. It don't matter. He's on fire. It don't matter who's in his way right now, because he is just slapping threes left and right. It's a 10-point game, 2 minutes to go. We go to Michael Beasley, little mid-range jumper. Hits that one. They need to update his cyber face, by the way, because that is not him. Raymond Felton misses that three ball, and we get off and running on this fast break. Every time they miss, we get loose. Frank kicks it out. Look at this beautiful ball movement. Look at that ball movement. Kristaps Porzingis finishes that little baseline jumper to make it a 6-point game. Back come the OKC Thunder, and that completely kills any momentum that we had built up to that point. But this game's not even close to being over yet. As Frank got the ball right here, trying to create, goes all the way to the lane and finishes. A nice move right there. We're just going to call him Frank, okay? I don't know how to say the man's last name. I'm not going to embarrass myself or offend anybody by completely destroying his last name. So we're just going to call him Frank for the time being until we learn how to pronounce that name. Kristaps Porzingis. Look at that ugliness. That, if you guys want a definition for ugly, that would be it. I mean, this man just threw the ball off of the backboard with two hands. Somehow got the and one. Tim Hardaway Jr. Give this man a picture. I don't know why his profile is blank. He needs a picture. But he knocks down that three ball right there. And it's Kanter working that glass, grabbing the O-Rep, going back up with it, making a 5-point game. OKC Thunder is shook. But look at me. Where's the defense? I'll be honest with you guys. I was taking a bite of food on that play. Okay, I'll be real. I was eating while playing this game. Frank with a nice drive right there. The rookie takes it amongst everybody. But check, this is my favorite play of the game. We get the switch. I'm like, all right, let's pull this back out. Let me create. He goes stumbling. I'm pulling the three ball and banging that one. Frank, take it easy, man. Take it easy. So they make it a 4-point game off that layup right there. I'm going back to Frank. He's crossing up everybody. Mid-range. No, he misses that one, unfortunately. I thought we had a nice little rhythm going. But the OKC Thunder, look at this three ball. Thankfully, they missed that one. But the offensive rebounds once again, man. Steven Adams was killing us in this fourth quarter on the O-Rep. So they build a 6-point lead once again. And Russell Westbrook, man, pulls back. He steps back, drains that three ball to make it a 7-point game. So this game is slowly slipping away from us as OKC Thunder start making these tough plays. Tough layup right there from Paul George. They get it to go to make it a 9-point game. A minute and 30 to go. We need something. Porzingis, no, he misses the layup. So we just went stone cold in this fourth quarter, towards the end of this fourth quarter to be exact. And Russell Westbrook just not slowing down, throws down another dunk. So that's going to be it for game number one. Man, if you guys enjoyed the video or if you guys like the new mic, make sure to leave a like, hit that like button, and make sure to drop a comment. Let me know what you guys think. So thank you guys for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, man, make sure you hit that like button. And if you're new here, subscribe.